I was made merely in the image of God, but not otherwise resembling him enough to be mistaken for him by anybody but a very nearsighted person. I believe that our Heavenly Father invented man because he was disappointed in the monkey. Mark Twain.
He was a Southerner and a Northerner, a Westerner and a New England Yankee, a tireless wanderer who lived in 1,000 places all around the world. He would call just 2 of them home, the Missouri town of his childhood, which he would transform into the idealized hometown of every American boy, and the magnificent Connecticut house he built for his wife and children, which he hoped would shelter them from hardship, but where heartbreak found them nonetheless. During his long life, he was a printer's apprentice and a riverboat pilot, a prospector who never struck gold, and a Confederate soldier who never fought a battle. He was considered the funniest man on earth, a brilliant performer on the lecture circuit, who could entertain almost any audience, and a spectacularly inept businessman whose countless schemes to get rich quick threatened again and again to bring him to ruin. But above all, Mark Twain was a writer, a natural-born storyteller, and a self-taught genius with words, who understood before anyone else that art could be created out of the American language.
The genius was for speaking the voice of America, for internalizing and then flawlessly reproducing the voice of the American people.
He wrote as though there had been no literature before him, as though he had discovered the art of telling a story about these folks that inhabit this continent. And that there was no other continent. It's like something that rose up out of the sea and had no history. And he was just telling what he ran into.
He made American speech something to be admired. The European language was supposed to be the ideal. But he just, he idealized the American language. And he used the way we talk and turned it into literature.
He wrote constantly, newspaper stories, poetry, plays, political diatribes, travel pieces, irreverent musings about religion, and a series of autobiographical sketches noted as much, he admitted, for the tall tales they spun as for the truth they told. And he wrote books, books read by millions, including the deceptively simple story of a backwoods boy and a runaway slave that showed his people a whole new way to think about themselves.
I think Mark Twain understood that if we were going to be a country, if America was going to be the nation that it started out to be, the problem of race had to be solved. And I think he realized that it wasn't being solved. Mark Twain told the truth. He saw what we were about and was not afraid to deal with things that other people were afraid to deal with.
Like the nation he would come to embody, he was always reinventing himself, always restless, always full of contradictions. "I am not an American," Mark Twain said. "I am the American."